a key takeaway is that there's legitimate hope, legitimate expectations that these new approaches and new ideas about approaches will transform the way we treat the disease.
Hope that is desperately needed for patients and families fighting ALS. Researchers at UMass Chan Medical School are pioneering a treatment that in one early trial appears to suppress the ALS gene known as C9, commonly seen in one form of the disease.
It's a form that accounts for about half of the familial cases and actually about 5 to 10% of sporadic cases. So it's the largest group that we can identify with one known cause. So we're pretty excited.
The research published in the journal Nature focuses on a single patient trial where the treatment was shown to stabilize or slightly improve symptoms. But Dr. Robert Brown has hope that it could eventually roll them back and the impact could be wider than that.
The platform itself seems to be safe. So if we can now take the molecule and change it for other types of ALS, it may be that the whole delivery system is safe across the board. This is what we call personalized medicine. With some of the new approaches, one can, for example, turn down toxic genes or turn up genes, which are okay, but are not functioning at a high enough level.
Dr. Brown says awareness efforts like the Ice Bucket Challenge have made a huge difference in pushing ALS research forward, something he's been passionate about since he began studying the disease back in the 80s.
It's a dreadful disorder that seemed to merit as much help as we can all muster.
Well, the next step is to expand the trial to more patients, which could happen in just a few months. Dr. Brown says he's optimistic that we will see major changes in how we're able to treat ALS in the coming years.